Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back. We are back with some more Mobile Legends and we've got a brand new thing we are calling the Mobile Legends Update Podcast. We have with us ASK Vell and RumblySuperset. What's up guys?
What's going on?
We are basically about to take a look at the update patches for 1.1.80, and it's got a lot to it, a lot of changes, especially for mages. Right out the gate, we got Aurora. We already know the price was 24k battle points, 499 diamonds, and she's on sale for 30%, which will equal to about 349 diamonds for her. Background story: Aurora, born in a windstorm and with a powerful and controlling ice storm, is the queen of the northernmost land, Nazgul, the dominator of the frozen sea and the guardian of the land of Dawn. Although they are on this northernmost land, Aurora never had any interest with the conflicts between Franco and Bane. She was born powerful and extraordinary. As one of the four guardians of the land of Dawn, she undertakes all those responsibilities of protecting the world, protecting its border, and ensuring its safety from the space-time rifts and monsters. During a horrible plane fight, Aurora lost one arm along with her guardian knight. After this experience, the young queen became solemn and cold, silent and full of sorrow. And when she's riding on the wind travels, there's only snow and ice keeping her company. We did go over skills as well in both of our videos, Vell and myself's. Pride of Ice, of course, is her passive. Each time her skill is released, one unit of frost energy will be added to a hero. When four units of frost energy is collected, the next skill damage will freeze the target and skills that cause extra magic damage to the frozen target. The A ability, which is her first skill, fires forward a frost energy missile. When it hits an enemy, it will detonate and deal magical damage and slow down the enemies. Her second ability, Bitter Frost, deals magic damage to the target with additional small scale slowdown effect, and her ultimate being Coldness Destroy. It summons a giant icy rock to bombard a designated target location. All enemy heroes will be hit and slowed down and receive magic damage. Now, surrounding enemies of the target location where the rock lands will also be slowed down and receive magical damage. Wow. That was a mouthful. Yeah. So, about this chick, the background story is pretty interesting. For one, it ties her into kind of Bane and Franco, which are the only two other characters that we know of are from this land that they called Nazgul. And we're starting to actually learn a little bit more about the story of what they're creating, this game is becoming. Like, they're tying people together. These newer characters are falling in and tying into like some of the older characters, like Bane. Bane's from Nazgul. Bane's at some type of war with Franco, so these two don't get along, but it also states like she's not in this conflict, so she's out there by herself.
Yeah, and that's one thing that I actually found pretty interesting about this is that when I first joined the Mobile Legends community, I asked the developers, yo, are you gonna have like storylines? Are these characters gonna be related to each other? Are they gonna connect in any way? And I was told no, they're focusing on competitive and stuff like that. But it seems like they're actually taking the direction of this more into connecting the characters a little bit more and giving us that attachment, because I feel like the Mobile Legends community, I know myself included, we're like becoming engulfed in the characters. We want to know more about them. We want to feel more for them. Kind of like you see in the Overwatch community. That's something that we really want. We're interested in the characters. We're interested in the skins and stuff. Like, so this is becoming a big deal, and I think the developers are actually taking the right step, implementing more of these relationships into the game.
I do agree.
Definitely the immersive aspect of it is really nice, because they do the same thing in like Vainglory, where they have a lot of lore-oriented content. And even though it's not really directly influencing gameplay, like it really affects how the player feels about the character and how much he wants to play that character. So it's really cool to see them doing that in this game too.
Yeah, it draws them more to the characters. Also, like in that it stated, she's like one of four guardians of the land of Dawn. Now I'm assuming the land of Dawn is like this certain area in this place that they're at. I haven't done complete research on the background stories, but you know, it's saying she's only one of four, so this could possibly lead to hints that there are possibly going to be three more guardians that they could release.
Yeah, and that's going to be dope. It would actually be sick as if they release these guardians and they're like all four different roles, and if you select each of them, they have some type of Quattro ability that they can do to the other team or something. That's something like that would be crazy.
Some kind of ultimate. Some Hamekame.
Yo, I would love it.
That would be really dope. And as far as her skills go, like, she falls in with, you know, anything you would think of as ice, you know, slowing somebody down and helping control them. And that's what she's going to do. She's going to do a lot of damage and just slow people.
Yeah.
It'd be cool if they introduced, like, some sort of voice lines that are only active, like, only apply when they're nearby each other, like the Guardians.
Yeah.
So, like, in-game, you can hear them talk to each other. Like, it's kind of like this playful talk.
Yeah, that,
like
that
they're
would
having
be
conversations
amazing.
Back and forth. Yeah, that would be really cool. I don't think I've ever really seen that in a MOBA style game.
No, it'd be really cool.
Nope. I first saw that in like Overwatch. Actually, I've compared it to Overwatch a lot because I actually like that game. But yeah, like when the hero Ana goes near Reaper, she has a specific voice line, and it's crazy seeing that because you know that they have history.
Yeah, it shouldn't be too hard to do either. I mean, they would just have to add in codes to trigger audio points at certain distances away from each other.
Yep, and that's huge for a game.
Yeah, that'd be just huge for interaction and overall make it sound cooler.
Right.
So getting on to the rest of this, the next hero rotation and skins, they're looking like Ballman, Akai, Franco, Nana, Karina, Minotaur, Hayabusa, and Chao. Of course, the Starlight members, you guys get extra skins: Alice, Adora, Kagura, Alpha, Ruby, and Johnson. And I meant heroes, not skins. I'm sorry. And they're releasing another 2 weeks again on this. So the next week, you'll have Alice, Saber, Clint, Lolita, Adora, Sun, Kagura, and Natalia. And Starlight members have Nana, Fanny, Minotaur, Chao, Ruby, and Cyclops in that one. It looks like that one almost kind of just reverted a little bit.
Really?
Yeah. So the Starlight members, most of those are in this upcoming week's regular rotation. So we might be able to find a pattern with that. And also, Chao, he's finna be on sale for a limited time, 30% off. I might actually pick him up because I have not played Chao yet.
Yo, I'm actually excited about this one because, for once, I'm a freaking Starlight member thanks to the new Moskov skin. So, that's dope. I had to get that
immediately.
Yeah, definitely. That's a must get in Mobile Legends. If you're a Mobile Legends fan, you got to get that.
And, of course, the new hero skin for Aurora, the Nature's Throne. 269 diamonds. Not bad for a brand new character's skin, honestly.
Yeah, I'm just mad that I thought, based on the little background that they gave with her, I really thought that she was going to be elemental based. Like, I thought we were going to see some, like, her abilities switching from ice and to
earth. Yeah.
But yeah, it's
That'd
just
cool.
Yeah,
I had
they
the same,
just made it icy still.
I had the same thought because when we saw that footage of that skin and then she just still raises up the same icy throne, I was a bit disappointed because, I mean, she's got all the vines, the leaves, and the, you know, the earthy elemental look. It would have been really cool to see them have like some kind of earth golem, you know, behind the throne, and, you know, like a, I don't know, a dirt something cool kind of throne with vines and stuff all over it, you know, more immerse themselves in the, you know, the skins as well instead of just singling out just a single target.
Do you know what level of skin this is? Like, you know how there's like epic and then like there's like standard skins, you know?
We haven't got any information on that yet.
Yeah, we don't know that just yet. But I think that it makes me feel like they just said, okay, this is something that I think looks cool. Let's just give it to her. Let's just make that happen.
Yeah.
Because it didn't seem like it was too much thought behind that. It looks like they just wanted to get another skin to throw out with it, which I don't have a problem with adding another skin. It kind of don't make sense and I have a problem with that. It needs to make sense for me, but I mean,
it's definitely a missed opportunity for sure.
Definitely. Yeah, they could have done so much better. Like an animation, just like freaking roots coming out of the ground and forming a chair for this skin. Like that would have been badass. Everybody would have bought this skin, yo.
Right,
everybody
exactly. And I'd pay double what they're charging for this one if they would have done that.
Yeah, exactly.
So
exactly.
They also are adding in demonstration voices for Ruby's new skin, the Hidden Orchard Butterfly, which just came out today as of when we're recording this. So that's pretty cool.
That skin looks pretty cool too, yeah.
Because the wolf howl when she used her ultimate with that skin, it really didn't make much sense because, I mean, the original skin was the wolf. So
yeah.
I don't know what butterflies sound like, but hopefully it sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, we can only hope.
All right, next we have hero balance adjustments. Quite a few got some changes. Let's dig into them, see what they got. Alice, up on the block again. Blood Ode, Her initial spell vamp adjusted from 30, 55, and 80 to 40, 60, and 80. So she got more lifesteal from spell vamp at earlier on in the in the phase.
Yeah, so that's not bad. That's actually I don't see that as a problem.
It's the same on the end, but earlier games she'll have more spell vamp from it.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Now, Bauman, hero role adjusted from fighter tank, recommended gear sets adjusted. Oh, so Bauman's considered a tank now.
Yeah. Okay. Subsidiary tank, I guess.
Now, Avatar Primal Fury skin has been optimized. Really?
Oh, so that's okay. Gonna look a little bit better. I think that's, is that what they did to like Franco and Tigreal, or is that like the just a little square image part that's been updated?
The avatar, I would assume, is just the square image.
Yeah.
So it's not a full overhaul on him just yet, but I'm sure he was in that list actually that we had seen.
Oh yeah, that's right.
So he'll be up on the block soon. Chao, they fixed a bug that the skill descriptions of only fast did not match its actual effect. Okay. Hayabusa fixed the bug that Hayabusa would go invisible when he cast the skill and the target just dies at the same time.
I love that description, dude.
That's great. Lolita, they fixed the bug of unable to specify the direction of her ultimate skill when there's enemy units. Now, I believe me and Rumbly played a good bit. He played with Lolita a good bit. Did you have any trouble with her ultimate the other day, like targeting any certain directions?
I don't know. I'm still new to the game, so I'm kind of just spamming.
that makes sense.
But I mean, I didn't really see an issue, but I guess maybe it's like not every time, maybe?
Right.
I think that it just goes up and you gotta keep it in that direction. Maybe she can turn with it now. Could that be what they're talking about?
That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, if you can turn while it's actually going.
If you're hitting the ultimate, who would just hit something and then point in the direction that no one's there? You see the guy walk behind you, you just keep looking the other way.
He's not there. All right. Hilda, hero's specialty adjusted to regen / damage. Hilda is no longer categorized as a tank. No, actually, she still is. That's just her specialty. I'm sorry. Regen and damage now.
Not bad. Okay.
Well, the regen makes sense. The damage.
Item. Yeah.
Yeah, so. Alpha, they recommended gear has been adjusted on him. And Karina, hero poster has been optimized. Okay, cool.
Yeah, she's one that needed one for sure. It didn't match.
Yeah. The next up is Battleground spells and gear adjustments. We got a lot of changes, and a lot of this is focused around mages. Like they had said, we talked about this in the Q&A videos a couple back. I don't know how many back, but we've done so many. But yeah, go check them out. We talked about that then, but they did change a lot with the mage pretty much overall gear. I mean, Concentrated Energy, which has the unique spell vamp, they increased that from 25% to 30%, and they adjusted the price down from 2120 to down to 2020. So you get more spell vamp from it, and it costs less now.
That's a good buff.
That is very good. That only concerns me with like somebody like Karina that uses.
Yeah, that's my biggest concern. All of this stuff.
Yes, that was my initial thought. Was like when they said they were about to buff mages and change mage gear, that just immediately processed in my head. Karina is about to become severely strong with all of this because everything is about to get really cheaper from her. She's not going to get any slower. She's still an assassin. She's just going to be doing more damage earlier because she's got cheaper gear now.
So they may adjust her ratios then in accordance to that?
I would say within the next two patches, you'll probably see them going to adjust the damage output for Karina and try to balance it back out.
Right,
she's gonna be one that makes everybody rage, and when the community starts to rage, they make changes. So
really,
I'm definitely gonna be using her at the beginning of this season while she's OP, not really OP, but while she has like a slight boost
statistical advantage.
Glorious legend, here I come.
All right, so they changed pretty much a lot of the gold on the rest of these. They did optimize visual effects for one, which was Deadly Blade, the Life Drain passive on it. The price adjustments were Enchanted Talisman 1970 to 1870. Winter Truchen. It looks like all of these have been lowered by just 100 gold. It looks like that's what pretty much all of them are. But the rest of them are Winter Truchen, Feather of Heaven, Astral Ward, Frost, Eternal Scepter, Calamity Scythe, Guardian Relic, Flame of Fury, Blood Wings, and Fleeting Time.
Yeah, that's a decent amount. That's a decent chunk there.
Yeah, so overall, that set, I mean, if you're building into a full mage set, you're saving immediately 600 gold overall.
Yeah. Yep. So that's huge. Huge for mage players.
Yeah, that's a turtle kill and then some. Yep. So if you want to compare it to something, that kind of gives you something to compare it to. Battleground adjustments. They optimize the floor details of the map around the altars and turrets to make it more suitable to the world concept of Mobile Legends. So they're still optimizing on the map, trying to make it look better. I like that.
Then some really big ones are coming too, so that's going to be really dope.
Yeah,
a lot of changes to the map.
See, they optimize the skill mechanism of the Lord. The crowd stun effect now changed to avoidable crowd knock airborne effect, which will allow players to have fun of strategies when fighting against the Lord. Every five attacks from the Lord, an energy beam will generate under the feet of his enemies. 1 second later, it will knock airborne enemies into the beam and deal damage to them. What?
What is that?
This is crazy.
He's just going to be knocking people in the air. I like
they got rid of the crowd stun, and it's instead of the whole stun, now he's slamming the sword in the ground. A beam that comes up under you. I'm assuming you have 1 second to dodge this beam. So if you react fast enough, you can actually dodge it.
He feels more like a boss now, though, you know?
That, and you could actually use that to your advantage when people are trying to steal Lord from you. So if he goes to do that, you know, that pops, you just move out of it and somebody runs into it, it pops them up in the air. Then you got the advantage on them trying to gank you.
Someone's Jason, you just love tap the Lord.
It's going to be hilarious, yeah.
Help me out here.
It's going to be amazing. I actually like this, man.
And they did adjust the attack range on Lord and Turtle. They dropped it from 5 down to 3.3, so they almost cut it in half.
That's good, though, because he actually had like extended range. Which
yeah, he had a really, really, really far range. That was quite annoying.
Yeah.
System adjustments. Friend system optimized. This optimization is for Android system, and the moment iOS users need to wait for the next update. I'm sorry, Vell. And Rumbly.
Well, luckily, but I just got an Android.
That's
so.
Right. You're welcome, bro.
I just get rid of mine.
Yep.
They optimized the loading method of the friends list in the inbox. Now players can scroll the list up and down more smoothly. Thank you! Oh my goodness. That has been annoying to try to scroll through that list and it just lag out and you're not be able to do anything.
The ease of life update, nice.
Added the blacklist feature to Facebook friends. That's cool. Now players can go to the inbox, Facebook friends, and their Facebook friends to the blacklist. Consequently, they will show in the blacklist instead of Facebook friends list. You won't receive messages or invitations from them. Of course, you can cancel the block in the blacklist to allow them to show up again in your friends list. Okay, that makes sense. So you can block people that's on your Facebook friends if you're connected with your Facebook.
Yeah.
Keep people from spamming you. They optimized the following interfaces to make them brand new: the heroes list, the shop page, and recharge page. Okay, that's so nice. Three pages got revamped on the interfaces.
You're getting some nice new UI.
Yeah, it's good to see some better looking things, because they've been going crazy with the visuals, honestly. I can give them that, and I'm happy to see that. It's been a long time coming, and it's good that they're finally doing it now. Fixed the lag, I'll be happy.
I agree. They optimized the display of Arabic language. They can't speak it, can't read it. So, yeah, if you do, that helps. They optimized the live stream system. So this thing I've still not completely figured out yet. I don't think me or Vell or Rumbly have either. But
no clue.
The languages category added now the system will classify the live streaming according to player's system language. I like that. adds tags including hot new girl streamer and the world best. Okay, we see where this one is going. Our devs are obviously feminists.
They brought in the girl streamer for you, Solbash.
All right, no, right? We can get somewhere now. They improved the rule of recommendations for live streams. Recommendations will be made according to popularities for streamers. Today's popularities will be calculated a new day every day. According to streamers, daily views, gifts received, and newly gained followers. So you're pretty much, it's starting to become like YouTube. Whoever gets the most interactions is going to get the most clout. So that's pretty much what that means.
Yep.
Improve the director perspective in the live stream. Now the view of spectators is the same as it is of the streamer. I've never used it, so I didn't know it was any different. Also, live streaming spectating optimized. After sending flower jewelry, players can click on the gift and send items consecutively within the countdown time of combo. Okay. Still not sure what that is. Optimize the visual effects for the different layers for scrolling the chat messages and gift sending messages, and they optimize the rule chat messages sending. Now players are not allowed to send the same messages consecutively. No more spam.
Yes.
Yes. That's always good.
So yeah, that's a lot. That's a big update, guys. Really, like a lot bigger than what you've kind of noticed a pattern in the past couple updates. Have I been the only one that's noticed that, Vell?
Which pattern is that?
Well, you get a character and skin in one update with hero balances, and then the next update you're just getting skins and smaller changes. It's not as big. It's giving them more time to put more energy into those bigger updates.
Oh yeah, actually that makes a lot of sense now that you point it out.
Yeah.
That's probably why they're becoming more productive. They actually have a pattern, and it's not as random as it was when we first.
Yeah, they're
when
starting.
When I first joined, definitely.
Starting to become pattern. There's a system that they're starting to get down a lot better, as far as everything, even with their content, social media, and stuff like that. It's becoming better over time.
Yeah. There's probably a question that everybody's probably wondering: is like, when is the actual release of this update?
So the actual release, I can go ahead and say it's not going to come any further than next Monday, which the date on next Monday would be the 8th of May. So that is the earliest we're going to see it, is the 8th of May.
Gotcha.
The latest is going to be is the 10th of May. So anywhere between May the 8th and May the 10th, that's when this update will go live.
Very nice.
You guys have anything else to add?
Nah, that's pretty much it. We've pretty much covered everything. Plus, I'm still sick, so I'm trying not to talk a lot, but yeah.
All right, well, that's going to pretty much wrap it up for the very first episode of the Mobile Legends Update Podcast. If you guys enjoyed this conversation, if you want to be a part of this conversation, you can do so in the comments below, because we will be reading them. We'll be also checking up on Vell as well on his comments. I'll be there as well. So make sure you comment, make sure you like the video, because it does help us out a lot. And yeah, that's going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. As always, like, comment, and subscribe. I'm Solbash.
I'm Vell.
And I'm Rumbly.
You guys have a nice day.
Peace out.
Later.